Hello and welcome to another Mindbreeze tutorial. Today we will be looking at the initial setup of the Mindbreeze appliance, network configuration, and support platforms available to you. To rack the appliance, two rack units of space in a 19-inch server rack will be necessary. After installing in our rack, it's time to wire up our appliance. We will need at least one Ethernet LAN connection for our Idrac and one for the main appliance, but it is recommended to have extra connections for redundancy reasons. Two PSUs are available to us. It's recommended that we power both, each on a separate power circuit. After we have successfully connected our power and Ethernet cables to the appliance, we will be able to access the LCD panel at the front of the machine. Using this panel, we can configure the IP address of Idrac. Idrac will allow us to remotely administer the appliance, so it is important that we get this up and running first. If you have DHCP, we can navigate to the right to view and click OK, and then on Idrac IP, hit OK again. Now we can choose IPv4 or IPv6 and select the one appropriate for your infrastructure. Let's now select IP, and we can see the IP address assigned to the Idrac. This will be used to connect remotely to the Idrac web interface. If you require a static IP address, we can do this by navigating to Setup and then to Idrac. Here, we can set up DHCP or static IP addresses. If we want to change the static IP, we can select this and using the arrow keys and select button, change each number of the IP address individually. When done, navigate to the end and click OK. We can now do the same for the subnet mask and for the gateway IP addresses if necessary. If we want to, we can also set up one or more DNS servers in the same way which we have done for our IP addresses. To save, simply click OK. After we have set up our Idrac to have an IP address for our network, we can access it remotely via a web browser. Let's navigate to the assigned IP address of the Idrac in the web browser, remembering to use HTTPS at the start. Accept any certificate errors which may pop up. We can now log in with the username root and password appliance123. Here, we can see a dashboard with an overview of our system, and we can see that the system is currently switched off. We can turn it on remotely here with the power on system button. As well as offering in-depth reporting and monitoring of the appliance, Idrac also allows us to connect remotely via a virtual console. Let's open this now. If necessary, simply accept the SSL certificate error if it appears. When connected, we can see that Mindbreeze Inspire is booting up. Let's wait until Mindbreeze has booted successfully and we see the login screen until continuing. Before we configure our network settings, we should first check on the status of the network devices on the appliance. Let's navigate to System, Network Devices, and then click on Integrated NIC 1. Here we can see that one of the four available NICs for the Mindbreeze appliance is connected. The best practice is to connect at least two of these NICs for redundancy reasons. Now we have confirmed that the appliance is networked, let's configure the network settings. First, let's return to our virtual console and log in with the user config and the password appliance123. The config user will give us access to the network management tool. We want to change the config, so let's enter 1 and hit enter. Now we will navigate to edit a connection with the arrow keys and again hit enter. Now we can see that we already have one network bond set up by default. This is the connection we need to edit with our infrastructure specific settings. Let's hit enter to select it and press edit on the right hand side. We can see here that by default, all four network devices supplied with the appliance are added to this bond in an active backup mode for redundancy. This is the recommended best practice mode. Here, we can configure the IP configuration either using the automatic setting or manually. With manual settings, we can also configure the gateway and DNS servers along with the search domains. After we have made our changes, we can navigate to the bottom of the config with the arrow keys and hit OK to save and return. Then outside, we hit back, and then when at the main menu, hit OK. Mindbreeze will now apply these changes and restart the appliance if necessary. To set the hostname, we can simply log in with the config user again, as before, and enter the network management tool and select Set System Hostname. Then enter the name required and confirm with OK, and then hit OK. The appliance will apply these settings and reboot if necessary. Once we have correctly configured and networked the Mindbreeze appliance via Idrac, we should be able to reach the appliance's management center directly via web browser. To do this, navigate to the assigned IP address or hostname of your appliance, followed by the port 8443. Please note that you should use HTTPS when connecting here. Log in with your supplied credentials, the username admin and password appliance123. Please note that on your first login attempt, you will be prompted to change the default password to one of your choosing. Please do so carefully. Once logged in, we can navigate to the Mindbreeze search client. If everything has worked, we should then be able to search over the test indexed shipped with every appliance, the web data source. When this works, your appliance was racked, networked, and started successfully. Congratulations! Now let's take a look at the support platforms available to you as a customer of Mindbreeze. In total, there are three different portals which you can use depending on the support you need. Tickets.mindbreeze.com, answers.mindbreeze.com, and help.mindbreeze.com. As well as these three main portals, you can also visit developer.mindbreeze.com for our SDK and code snippets, search.mindbreeze.com to search over all portals, and mindbreeze.com/academy to book training sessions with us. Let's start first with tickets.mindbreeze.com. Here you can submit tickets to Mindbreeze support. The tickets can have different categories associated with them, so you can get the support you need. Firstly, we have documentation request. Select this option if you feel something is either missing or incorrect in our documentation found at help.mindbreeze.com. Our support team will check this and make sure to update our documentation as fast as possible if a change is required. Next, we have configuration conversion. If you have an old config which you would like to restore or have a GSA config XML, open your ticket with this category and we will work with you to convert this to a workable format with our current product. If you require additional professional services, select Mindbreeze Professional Services and describe your requirements in the ticket. If you would like to get help directly from one of our consultants, you can select Request Consulting. Please note, if you have no support package available for this, we will first send you an offer for a consulting package. If you need a feature which is not already included in Mindbreeze, or if you have some ideas which you feel would improve Mindbreeze, please select Feature Request. Finally, if you have a technical problem with your appliance, either software or hardware, select Report a Problem. You can check on the status of your ticket at any time through the tickets.mindbreeze.com portal. Now, let's open a ticket with Report a Problem as an example. When we open a ticket, especially if it concerns a problem or issue with the product, it is important that we are as specific as possible and follow the provided instructions. Doing so will increase the speed at which the engineers can diagnose and resolve your problem. Product issues must be reproducible for the support engineer. Therefore, we need to make sure we include a few things. Firstly, a description of the product issue, and then a description of the infrastructure constraints in which the problem is reproducible. As well as this, we will need significant logs, for example from AppTelemetry, that describe the product issue, which help our support team to understand the cause of the problem. We will also need a step-by-step description of how the problem can be reproduced, as well as concrete files if these are the cause of the problem. The exact version and build number in use are also necessary. For premium support customers, please remember to make sure you are logged in to issue a premium support ticket. We can add all of this information in the given form below, including attachments, videos, and links. Tip: adding logs is a very useful way to attach large pools of data associated with your issue, which an engineer can analyze. Please make sure to also include the release and version number. Next, let's take a look at answers.mindbreeze.com, our FAQ and Q&A forum. Please note, you will need to register to be able to use answers.mindbreeze.com, as it's only permitted for customers and partners. When you register, for free, your account will be approved by us as quickly as possible. Once approved, you can then sign in. In answers.mindbreeze.com, common occurring misunderstandings and misconfigurations are clarified and explained. Common use cases, best practices, and use case-oriented documentation can be found here, and customers can then enter into a dialogue surrounding these topics. Let's move on to help.mindbreeze.com. Here, we'll be able to find all general documentation surrounding Mindbreeze Inspire, including different connectors, plugins, the SDK, and the search API. Simply navigate via the tree on the left-hand side, or search using the search bar at the top to find the documentation you need. The documentation has clear and easily navigable sections and is also available in a PDF format. If we are more interested in the development side of things, we can navigate to developer.mindbreeze.com. Here, you will find our SDK, as well as code snippets and quick start guides. Search.mindbreeze.com offers a quick search portal with which you can search over all of our support platforms. If you have a concrete question such as, how can I install an update, just search for it here. Next, we have mindbreeze.com/academy. Here, we are able to browse different training courses offered by Mindbreeze and also view upcoming dates and register and sign up for new courses. Finally, we have mindbreeze.com, our main website. Here, you can see all areas of Mindbreeze, including, for example, the support page, where we can find links to all of the previously mentioned portals.